when there is a contact of different type of molecules, liquid and solid, these are the two components, there will be air also. Like we keep the liquid in a solid jar. So there is a contact of liquid molecules, solid molecules, and here gas molecules. Air, this is liquid and this is solid. Now here we see there is a contact between molecules of liquid and molecules of solid. This contact is not a plane surface. Just where the contact is, the surface is not plane surface like this. Not this type of plane surface is there. We find either the surface rise up or it comes down. This is what we see with most of the pairs of liquids and solid. This is what we see as an example. This is glass and this is water. Every day we are using water in the glass, the surface is always like this. Maybe it is very small, we don't notice it, but if you see it very minutely, you will find it is there. Now, why this happens and what do we call it? There is a reason for this, and for that we have to understand that molecule to molecule force we have categorized into two classes. One is water to water force, same molecules, and other is water to glass. So if I put it this way, just magnified version of it, this is a water molecule, this is a water molecule, okay, and these are glass molecules. For this particular water molecule, on this side there is water molecule, on this side there is glass molecule. So the forces on both the sides are different. We have given them different names. The force for water to water, water to water, water to water, this force between the molecules is known as force of cohesion. And what is the condition? Similar molecules. But if we take the force between these two, this is water, this is glass. So this force is known as force of adhesion, that is the force between different molecules. Like we paste a gum on the paper, that is force of adhesion. Gum and the paper, different molecules. Okay, water to water is cohesive forces. So this is force of cohesion, force of adhesion. Now come here. This molecule is attracted by force of cohesion, force of adhesion. In some pairs, the force of cohesion is large compared to adhesion, and in some pairs, adhesion is larger than force of cohesion. Example, glass to water. If we have here water and here we have glass, water. This water molecule is attracted by this water. There is a force here, F cohesion. By this, F adhesion. In case of glass water pair, the force of adhesion is larger than force of cohesion. This is for glass water. What is the result of that? Result of that, see, this molecule is attracted by this molecule is also attracted by glass, and the force applied by the glass molecule is larger. Then what will happen? It has a influence circle like this. this has influence over this. Okay, this sphere of influence. Now what happens? Because the force between glass and molecule is larger, this is pressed towards glass. This also pressed towards glass. This also pressed towards glass. What is the result? This goes here at this point. This goes here. Then this will also push it. This goes up and this goes here. This another one will come here. What we find that this surface become like this. This. And this rise up wherever there is a contact. So what is the reason that liquid will rise at the point of contact? That is the force of adhesion, that is between water and glass, is larger than force of cohesion, that is liquid to liquid. So if this force is large, this will come towards solid, more and more pressing here, this becomes larger, they are pushing each other. So it becomes like this. Now here we measure the angle. How do we measure the angle here? This surface for the liquid, mind it, for the liquid, there is one surface here with the solid, there is one surface with the air here. What is in between that liquid? So we have to draw two tangents, one at this surface, one at this surface, and in between is the liquid. So this angle of contact for liquid to glass is acute angle. Acute angle. Why it is acute angle? Because force of adhesion is larger than force of cohesion. And for this we use another language, that water likes glass. And for this like, we use the word water spreads on glass. We use the other word, water wets glass. Wetting means it is going and going with the glass. Wherever it gets more glass, it will try to go there. And these are the examples of this. Here is water. Here is glass. You see, the water is trying to spread as much as possible on the glass. It is trying to cover more and more surface on the glass. We say it wets the glass. And in this process, if you measure the angle here, this is the angle, this. And this is acute angle. Here, when we have put the glass in a container, here is a tangent, here is a tangent. Do we take this angle or do we take this angle? Answer is, we have to take the angle which is within the liquid, not outside the liquid. This is having air in it, so this is not the angle of contact between liquid and the glass. This is angle of contact because here there should be liquid. So these two are acute angles. Acute angles of contact. Now see another example. This is an example where we are using mercury and this is glass. In mercury and glass, the force of adhesion is less than force of cohesion. Force of cohesion is larger. Mercury do not like glass. So mercury do not wet glass. It does not like glass. So the forces between mercury to mercury are larger. What will happen here? mercury, and here is glass. This force is less, this force is more. So it has resultant force in this direction. If this has resultant force in this direction, and this molecule, this also does not like glass. It has a resultant force here, it has a force here. So these two are coming in this way, applying force in this way. So these molecules move up, give them the place. And we see the surface here become like this. This is convex surface. This is concave surface. Okay. This is concave and this is convex liquid surfaces. And here mercury, do not wet the glass. If I put mercury on the plain glass, then it will try to cover the surface as small as possible. It does not like it. So here you see, it has increased the surface. In this case, it has decreased the surface. So this is mercury glass behavior. This is the reason. Adhesion is less, cohesion is more. They want to remain themselves together. So that is why they make a concave surface here. This is why they cover less surface here and they do not wet the glass. If we lift mercury, the whole mercury will come in our hand. There will not be a single particle on the glass. But in case of water, some water will always remain there because it wets the glass. So this is angle of contact. In this case, where is angle of contact? Do we have this contact? No, because there is no liquid here within these two lines. So this tangent we increase like this, and this is the angle what we are searching, and this is a obtuse angle. Angle of contact obtuse, force of cohesion is larger than force of adhesion, do not wet the glass, and the surface is convex. Please remember that all these four features are connected to each other. Once you are given any one feature, you should be able to connect up all the four features. What are these four features? Number one, force, adhesion and cohesion. Other is surface, convex, concave. Third is force, angle. Angle that will be obtuse and acute. And fourth is wetting. The one set, the above, glass, water. What do we find here? Force of adhesion is larger than force of cohesion. Surface, concave. Angle, acute. Wetting, wets. Mercury to glass. Force of cohesion is larger than force of adhesion. The surface is convex. Angle is obtuse. And do not wet. That is, it shrinks on the surface. It spreads on the surface. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and there is a fifth feature which we will be studying in the next lecture. That is, when we put them in the capillary. When we put a liquid on the capillary and the capillary is dipped in that liquid trough, then the liquid in this, will it rise up or will it go down? I will just write it, but in the next chapter we will study how it happens. So that is capillary behavior. Capillary. So here in this you will remember rise in capillary, and this is dips in capillary. Please remember this chart very thoroughly for surface tension. You will be given only one feature, that the force of cohesion is larger than force of adhesion. Will it rise in the capillary or dip in the capillary? Dips in the capillary. It is making a convex surface. Then, is it wetting the glass or it's not wetting the glass? It is not wetting the glass. So you will be given only one feature and you will connect up all the four features. Any one will give you the complete group. So please remember this group separate, this group separate. Any one quality will show you it belongs to this group and all features will be automatically there. So, this is about force of cohesion, force of adhesion, angle of contact, wetting the surface and making a convex or concave surface. Now, after this we will study if we put them in a capillary tube. What is that capillary tube? A very small diameter tube is known as capillary tube, and we put it in a trough. In the liquid, we fill it and put it in the, no, not fill it, we simply dip a capillary in the liquid. We find that this liquid, which was having this level, either rise up or it dips down. In some cases it will rise up, in some cases it will dip inside. This is what happens in two different cases. I will make it here. This is capillary. This is in a trough of liquid like this. And we find the surface here as convex surface, but that convex is below this normal surface. Here it is like this. So it has a dip. In this case, when we make the capillary, then here is a trough, here is the liquid, and we put a capillary tube in the liquid, a very thin tube. What we find that the liquid general level in the trough is this way, and this rise here this way. This happens, this belong to this group, this belong to this group. So please remember, this diagram one group, this diagram one group. Remember them separately. Okay, before we do the calculation of this capillary rise, before that we will study another thing, that is excess pressure inside a bubble. That we will do in the next lecture. Thank you.